Good morning, everyone. So last class, what we had discussed, can anyone tell? Yes, can anyone tell what we had discussed last class? Yes, Sahana wants to tell. So last class we discussed about what are files and how to open the file and which are the different modes we can open the file. How many modes were there in which we can open the file? Yes. Which were the different things with which we can open the file? How many modes were there? Six modes were there, no? Read, write.
Six modes.
Yes, six modes. Yes, right. That is read, write, okay, append, R plus, W plus, A plus. Yes or no? So that was there. Okay. Then we also saw something called what we saw again? We saw how to open a file. Which was the function to open the file? Yes, which was the function to open the file? It was fopen. And it had two parameters. Fopen, first was name of the file, comma, then purpose for what we are opening the file. So today we'll see how to close the files, how to read a file, how to write the file. Okay. So this is your continuation of second chapter, second session, file management in C. So, contents of today's classes, how to close a file. Okay, one function is there, fclose. So, using that, you can close the file. And also, what you can do is, which are the different input operation on file. What do you mean by input operation? Input means reading from the file. Okay, output means writing from the file. Then we will solve some quiz question. So how you would read from console? Already in C program, you would see the output, right? In console, one black screen would come, right? Output screen. What is that screen called? Whenever you will execute the program, one black screen will come. Okay, that is known as console. Okay, so whenever you wanted to read some value, you would use scanf in console. Whenever you want to write something, you would use printf. Yes or no? So now what is there? Now this is my file. Okay. Now there is one C program. Now C program always it would read from console. But now it wants to read from this file. So some functions will be there to read this from this file or to write in this file from C program. So we will study that today. So how to close a file? First we'll study how to close a file. We had opened the file, right? How we had opened the file? We had opened the file using file pointer. So we would declare f a file data type, okay, and star and any file pointer we would write. Okay, now when we have opened, maybe I have opened a file on file pointer fp. So to close it, I have to mention same. So a file must be closed as soon as all operation will happen. If you don't close, what will happen? Misuse of the file will take place. Okay. To avoid the misuse of the file, what we have to do is we have to close the file once you open. To close the file, we have one function, that is fclose. Okay. This is the syntax of the fclose. Fclose. Then inside that, write the name of file pointer. Your file pointer might be fp, p1, p2, p3, so on. Next is fclose. Okay, so now what is fclose? That is a C function which will close the file. Okay, so in this syntax, fclose is C function name. File pointer is close the file associated with the file pointer. Okay, this is the example. Fclose p1. Close the file associated with the file pointer p1. Okay, this is the example. Okay, so one example, what is there in this example? We have created two file pointers, star p1 and star p2. Okay, Then on P1, we are opening a file called input. In which mode? Can anyone tell which mode we are opening? Yes, it is W. W means write mode. So on P1, I'm opening a file called input. That pointer will point to the input file. Another P2 pointer. P2 pointer, I'll open the file output. In which mode? Read mode. So what I'm doing here is, okay, here what I can do, I can copy. Maybe I have two files like this. This is my input file. This is my output. Assume this is my input file. This is my output. So this file I have opened in read mode. This file I have opened in write mode. Okay. Or maybe this is, input I have opened in write mode, output in read mode. So what I can do, I can read from this file and copy it in this. Okay. For that, we need some input output operation, that is read write operation. And after doing all the operations, what we have to do, we have to close this file, input file and output file. How I have opened on the file pointer P1 and P2. Okay, so like this, I will close it. F close P1, F close P2. So did you understand how to open and close a file? We will just not open and close it. We have to do some operation. So dot, dot, dot is there. That is read and write operation. Okay, so first you should know how to open a file. Okay, to open a file, what are the conditions? Okay, that is in read mode, if you want to open, file should be already existing. If write mode means if it doesn't exist, it will create. If it exists, it will overwrite. Okay. So then after that, close the file. Okay. Then some of the input output operations on files. These are the operations. Copy it. You have so many operations. See, to to read or write in the file. Okay. So already you had to some functions to read and write in the console. Yes or no? Which were those? To read a character, you would use get ch, you would use, okay? To write, you would write put ch. Yes or no? And also you would use what? You would use scanf and printf. But for file, it is get ch and, get c, put c. So get C means it will take a single character, put C means it will put the, it will write the single character in file. This gets and puts, it is your C functions. Last year you had studied, no? It is to read and write on the console. What is console? That black output screen. But now I want to, don't want to write or read on the console. I want to write and read in the file to preserve it. Next is get W and put W function. Okay, get W means read an integer, put W means write an integer. Then comes F printf and F scanf. Okay, that is instead of you if reading or writing a single character, if you want to write string of character or read string of character, we use this. Okay. So first one I told you, get ch. Get means always remember, get from the file. Okay. Get c means get from the file. Get s means get, that is read in the console. Okay. Remember this. Get c is used to read a character from the file. Okay. I can read from the file and I can write it on the output screen. To write on the output screen, what I can use? I can use put S, or I can use printf, okay, to the write on output screen. But to write on file, we have to use put C if a single character. If you want to write more than one character, you can write F printf. Getting this? So remember, get C is to read a single character from a file. And syntax is C is equal to get C FP, that is name of the file pointer. Okay. What it will do, it will read a character from the file whose file pointer is fp2. Okay, this is used to read a single character from the file. To write a single character on a file, we use put c. Okay, put c, two parameters will come. What you want to write, c is nothing but character you want to write. Maybe you want to write A, B, C, D, anything. And file pointer, okay? How it is pointed. So this will write a character contained in the character variable C to the file associated with file pointer P1. So remember this, get Siemens, read from a file, single character, put Siemens, write in the file, single character, not writing on the console, okay, not writing on the output screen, but read and write in a file which you have opened by the file pointer has below. Here it is FP2, FP1, okay. Next, one program. This is a program to illustrate read data from keyboard, okay. What we have to do, first read data from keyboard, okay. Write it in the file input, again read the same from input file and display it on screen. Read the question once and try to understand what they're telling. First, what we have to do is, what you have to do? Read from keyboard. I should enter. So I can use getchar. Okay. Then I have to transfer that to the input file. So if I have to write in the input file, which mode I have to open the file in? Input file should be open in which mode if I have to write? It should be write mode. Again, read the same input. Again, that input file you have written, no? Open it again to read. So again, you close that file, open it in read mode, and to display on the screen, what you can use is printf. You can use printf or putchar. Okay. So getchar and putchar or printf or scanf. You can use for console, okay? For files, you have to use get C, put C, if single character, otherwise F printf, F scanner, okay? You understood the question? Yes, this program is there for your lab also, okay? So first what I'll do, I'll read data from keyboard. So for that, since I have a file, I'll declare a file pointer F1 and character C I'll declare, okay? Then first I'll read from keyboard and write in a file. So I'll open this input file in write mode. Okay. Then I'll go on reading from keyboard. To read from keyboard, I have to have getchar and I should read on the character. Single character, I'll read until end of the file. How you'll come to know end of the file? You'll press enter. Okay. And then you will write it in the same in file. To write in the file, we need put C function. What you want to write? Character C, okay? And the file is pointed by file pointer F1. Then close the file pointer. So you close that file. Again, open the file in read mode, okay? So again, open the file in read mode while C is equal to get C F1 is not equal to end of the file. Okay, now to read from the file, we need get C. Okay, Gayatri, want to tell something? Okay, so always remember, different function to read from file, different function to write from the file. To read, always it is get. Okay, to write, it is put. If it is single character, get C and put C for files, get char and put char for console. What is console? Your black output screen, okay? And this, or if you have a group of this a big sentence, that time you have to use printf scanf if it is for console, that black output screen. If it is your file, you have to use f printf. F stands for file. F printf means it will write in a file. F scanf means it will read from the file, okay? Next is get s and put s. So these are similar to get C and put C, but get S, what it will do? Get C would read a single character, okay? Put C would write a single character in a file, okay? Whereas this get S and put S will read, get S will read a string. String and character is different. Character means single alphabet, string means group of alphabet, okay? So this get S and put S are string oriented function used to read and write string again from the file, okay? If it was output screen, it was get, char and all. Using array, you could use, or a for loop. The general format of this get s and put s is like this. you can end in some compiler, you should write it as F. Okay, F should be there. If you write only get C, put C, get S, put S, in some programs will give error in some compiler. Okay, get S also is correct, but in some compiler it is F get S and F put S and F get C and F put C. So the general format is F put S. Put S means write the string into the file. So what string you should write, and comma name of the file pointer. To read again string, string size and fp will come. Okay. Next is get w and put w. Get w means, get c means you will get a single character. Get w means you will get a single integer. Okay. To read a single integer, one digit integer, we use get w. To write a integer in the file, we use put w. Okay, so this get w is used to read and put w is used to write integer value. Okay, and this is your syntax. Put w, see here, instead of character integer will come. Put w, which integer you want to write in file pointed by file pointer fp, and get w, which integer you want to read file pointed by fp. Next comes fprintf and fscanf. Okay, for you had printf and scanf, right? Same way you have fprintf, fscanf for files. Okay, so here the syntax is, in that you had only control string and list. Okay, here we will have where file pointer also we have to write. So name of the function is fprintf. Okay, and the file pointer is fp, then control string, percent d, percent s, percent c, okay, all those, or percent f, what is the data type that you can specify the control string and name of the variable, that is nothing but list. So they have given fprintf has three parameter, where fp is a file pointer associated with the file that has opened for writing, control string contained output specification for the item in the list. The list may include variable, constants and strings. Okay, and then one example they have given. So what it will do, file pointed by file pointer f1, it will write name, age and points. Next, fscanf. So fscanf, again it will read from where, a file. Okay, it will read from the file and write in the console. Okay, don't get confused. Fscanf means it will read from the file. Okay, fprintf means it will write in the file. So this, again, fscanf is the name of the function. File pointer fp, control string, list. It will cause the reading of the item in the list from the specified by fp. Okay, so again, file pointer name is f2. Percent s, percent d, item. Okay, item we are not using ampersand because string. Okay, for strings we don't use ampersand, but for character we need ampersand. Okay, so next one is ampersand quantity, because percent d, single integer, whereas percent s, set of character was there, ampersand we will not use. Okay, whenever array names will come or set of characters will come, name of the array or name of the string itself is a pointer to first address, so ampersand will not come. Okay, so because item is the name of the string, and by default name of the string will point to first address of the character, so it is address itself, name is only address pointing to first position, so ampersand will not come while reading. Any doubts you have till here? Just now we saw so many functions, put C and get C. Okay, then put W, get W, put S and get S, and F printf and F scanf. All this, what it will do, either read from the file or write into a file. Last year you studied read and write function, but from console, that black output screen. Now we are studying related to file. Okay, so we have one program, your lab program it is. okay, using fprintf and fscanf, that is to create a file with at least 5 records which consist of book number, book name, author, publisher and price. Okay, so what we will do is we will open a file, okay, and then we will write these all things, 5 records with the details like book number, book name, author, publisher and price. Again, write stdio.h, conio.h, open the main, okay? And what is the, we have to use, whenever you use files, you have to use file pointer, then declare all this. Book number is integer, I is for loop, price, okay? Then file name is there, which file name you want to write. Book name is array, author, publisher. So first they'll ask, what is the file name? Okay, enter the file name you want to give. Scanf percentage s, again when it is a file name is a array, so you need not write ampersand, okay, you can just write file name. Then f open, fp open the file in write mode because we have to write. Okay, what is file name? If directly file name you are writing, input and all quotes will come. Here I am taking the variable file name. In file name variable, name of the file is there. So when your variable name is there, you will not write quotes. Then printf, input in inventory data, printf, this all just to print. Then for I is equal to 1, I less than or equal to 5, I plus plus. If you want to start with I with 0, then end it with less than 5. Don't write less than or equal to 5. Then f scanf, okay. So whenever, one more thing, remember f scanf can be converted to scanf. Okay, if I want to make f scanf scanf, okay, so my console is nothing but standard input, so that time I should write the file name as standard input. This is like as good as writing scanf. Okay, so if I would write file name, it would read from file, but stdin means standard input, stdout means standard output. You can convert fprintf and fscanf equivalent to scanf and printf. If you write stdin while reading, okay, that is, it will become your console, and when you are writing, you have to use stdout. Okay, so I am reading here fscanf, stdin, from where I am reading, standard input, that is my black screen, book number, book name, author, publisher, price, and that is I'll type in the output screen, that will get, and then write it in my file pointed by file pointer fp. Okay, while reading ampersand and all is required, which for the things which are not array, while writing you need not have ampersand. Use proper control string. Book number is integer, percent d, book name is percent s, author, publisher, price, and after doing all, close the file and then get CH so that output screen will be held. Next, now just now we wrote in a file, now we'll display the same. To display it, again use a file pointer, use same parameters, and then open the file in read mode. Here see, I'm not taking variable, I'm directly writing the name of the file. What is the name of the file? My file. Okay, again I'll print same and take iterator, read from the file, print in the output device, that is output screen I will print. I'll just read from the file, and to display on the output screen I will print it. Try this program out, okay, you will get a clear understanding. Okay, so now let's see some of the quiz questions to see how much you have understood. Dash function must be used to close a file. Can you tell me which is that? Which is the function used to close a
file? B, ma'am.
F close.
F close.
F close it is. B, F close. Then in the statement file star P1, here P1 indicates. What does P1 indicates?
Pointer.
File pointer. Okay. File star P1 is there. Only int star P1 is pointer. This is file pointer. Answer is C. Then the operation of the get C. What it does? Get C means? Just now I told. Get C means B. Read a single character. From where?
B.
Get C is
read from? A character from keyboard.
It is keyboard. It's not from keyboard. Okay. It is from type. Get C, get S. Okay. Get W, F, scan F. All these are used to read from file. Keyboard, from the keyboard you learned last year. Get care, put care, scan F, print F. Okay. All those are this from in a normal standard input output devices. But from file you have used this. Then get S and put S are dash oriented functions. Which integer, string, character or none of the above?
String, ma'am.
Yeah, it is string oriented function. Because get S, what it will do? Read a string from file. Put S, write a string from a file. String means group of character. Character means single alphabet. Then get W. What is are dash oriented function. Which integer, string, character, none of the above? Get W and put W. What it does?
Integer.
Integer. Get W will read a single integer from file. Put W will write a single integer in file. The fprintf function performs dash operation. What it does? F means file. Okay. Print means write. Okay. It will write a set of data. Where it will write? If it was printf, it would write on standard output. That is on the screen. But this will write on where? It will write a set of data value to a file. You know, right? Print means write. Scan means read. Okay. Put means write. Get means read. Okay. That much you remember. And in this only we are studying about reading from file, writing in the file. Not standard input output. Standard input output you studied last year in C. Next, fscanf function performs dash operation. What it will do? Fscanf means read or write. Yes, fscanf means scan means read. Read and f means read from file. So it is read a set of data value from a file. Next, dash function is used to input operation on file. Which is that? Whether it is put C, put S. Yes. Used to input operation on a file. Input means read. Which is read function in this? It is get S. Okay. Get S, what it will do? Read a string from file. Get means read. Always get means read. Yeah, scanf means read. Okay. Put means write. Or printf means all PPP means write. Okay. G will come or S will come. It is what it is? Read. Dash function is used to this output operation on file. What is this? Which is which we can use for this output operation on a file. Output means read or write. Output means write. Dash is used to output operation on the file. Which it will be? That is to write on the file, which we can use. Put C. Okay. Answer is A. Then the function fprintf and fscanf performs IO operation on file. True or false? Input means read, output means write. It is true or false? Yes, it is true, no?
Yes, ma'am, true.
Yes, it is true. So let's see some important questions from your syllabus. Thank you. Today we have discussed next topic in the file, that is closing a file and input output operation on the file. Tomorrow we'll continue with error handling, but before that write the assignment question and execute the program. Okay, so important question on this is, so yesterday close we had not done, this you can write how to close a file and then explain get C and get char. What is the difference between get C and get char? Get C means read from file, get char means read from console, okay, or read from keyboard. Printf and fprintf means, printf means write on standard output, that is write on screen. Fprintf means write on the file. Then write the syntax, give the example, making two columns. Next. Then you have one more question. List and explain this question. List and explain input output functions of a file. So input means all the read functions of the file. Output means all write. So read are get C, get W, get S, okay, and F, scanf. Output means put W, put S, put C, and F, printf. Okay, these functions with all syntax, example for 10 marks you should write, not just one line. Okay, then lab programs associated with this. So today we discuss some programs now. Those are your lab program. I will again take one more class and show you execution, but before that writing. So three programs are there from this concept. Write a program to count the number of characters in a given file. So what you can do, you can open the file in read mode, okay, and go on counting how many characters are there in that. Next one, write a C program to create the file that has at least 5 records which consist of these. Just now we saw that. Open the file in write mode and write it. Then again, 8th one, okay, open that same file in read mode and read the content in the output screen. Okay, while writing, read from the keyboard, transfer it to file. While displaying from the file, okay, you have to read from the file and display on the output screen. Any doubts you have, anything you